Welcome back to the second video in the gold processing series using the heap leaching method. In this video, we will explore how to prepare the heap and its step-by-step process. I hope to subscribe to the channel to stay updated with all the new contents. Let's get started. The heap leaching process for gold extraction involves several key steps for heap preparation and gold recovery. I will explain these steps along with the main factors affecting the process. Part 1. Prepare heap leach full step. In the previous video, we discussed crushing the ore and agglomeration process. By the way, heap leaching method, it is very useful procedure in case we have high tonnage of ore but with low grade. Now we'll explain all the steps of the heap preparation. Step 1. We begin by preparing the designated area for the heap. This preparation is done using a grader to level the surface for the land with the presence of a surveyor who determines the intervals and sets the appropriate slope for the heap surface. The slope should direct towards the pregnant bond that holds the gold bearing solution. The heap area about 150 meters multiply 50 meters. Step 2. We lay out the heap liner plastic, which is made of impermeable materials such as plastic or clay, to prevent the leaching solutions from leaking into the surrounding soil. The material known as HDPE, high density polyethylene, must be ensuring its edges are securely fixed. We also make sure the ground surface is free from any rocks or stones that could puncture the liner and cause cyanide solution to leak into the ground. Step 3 and step 4 and step 5, we lay a cushioning layer on top of the liner and we spread sand over the cushioning layer. And step 5, we install the drainage pipes and adjust them to ensure proper flow direction for the gold bearing solution. Step 6, stacking the ore. The crushed ore is stacked in high layer heap on a lined platform as above. It is stacked evenly to ensure uniform distribution for the leaching solution. Part 2. Leaching solution application. A dilute cyanide solution, usually NaCn or CiCn, is sprayed onto the heap, allowing the solution to bilocate through the ore and dissolve the gold. As chemical equation that we discussed in previous video, Au plus NaCn plus O2 plus H2O equal NaCn plus NaOH, cyanidation equation. The correct method for spraying cyanide on the heap in gold extraction process requires precision and caution to ensure effective and safe gold recovery. Correct method for spraying cyanide: A. Heap preparation. B. Spraying cyanide. Heap preparation ensures that the heap is properly prepared with even layers and an adequate drainage system, as we see above. B. Spraying cyanide. The cyanide solution is sprayed onto the heap using a drip system or sprinklers. The spray should be evenly distributed across the entire surface of the heap. The spraying starts by pumping the cyanide solution from the barren pond by submersible pump. to the heap service, controlling the spraying rate, ensure that the spraying rate is not too high to avoid burning in certain areas, and not too low so that the heap is adequately wetted. We control the spraying rate through this gauge. Appropriate spraying rate. Generally, the typical spraying rate ranges from 10.20 liters per square meter per hour. The appropriate spraying rate depends on several factors, including ore particle size and permeability. Ore particle size. The particle size of the ore greatly impacts the efficiency of the leaching process. If the particles are too small, they may block the heap and prevent proper solution distribution. If they are too large, the surface area available for the solution to react with the ore is reduced. Number two, permeability. The heap must have high permeability to allow easy flow of the leaching solution. Proper ore crushing and avoiding overlay fine or coarse particles help maintain good permeability. Cyanide concentration. The cyanide concentration in the leaching solution must be in the barren pond must be carefully controlled. Excessive concentration can lead to chemical wastage, while insufficient concentration may reduce extraction efficiency. Prepare cyanide solution at a specific concentration, typically 0.05% to 0.1% of cyanide. Calculate the concentration in the laboratory through the titration process, as we explained in previous video, and we will explain in more detail in upcoming video about laboratory process. pH levels. The pH of the solution should be kept above 10 to ensure that the cyanide remains in its active form and to prevent the release of toxic hydrogen cyanide gas, as we mentioned in the previous video. Number 5, leaching time. The solution must be given enough time to react with the ore. The process can take weeks to months depending on the ore properties and the gold concentration. Part 3, bonds. Include barren bonds inlet and pregnant bonds outlet. Barren bond. In this bond, we add sodium cyanide at the concentration of approximately 0.05% to 0.1%, and when the cyanide concentration in the bond decreases, we add a barrel of NaCn weighing about 50 kilograms as shown in the image. After that, the solution is pumped to the surface of the ore collected in the heap. Pregnant bond outlet solution collection. The gold bearing solution is collected in a specially designed bond called the pregnant bond. After passing through the heap, where it becomes saturated with dissolved gold. We measure the concentration of gold by atomic absorption device. We will explain how it works in detail in the upcoming video dedicated to laboratory testing. Gold recovery from solution that bumping from being bombed by submersible pumps to the absorption column. The gold is extracted from the pregnant solution using methods as activated carbon absorption or electrowinning to recover the gold from the solution. We'll discuss absorption stage in detail in the next video. If you found the video helpful, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching and see you.